In this video, I'm going to take a look at the example in which we will have to sketch the plane curve defined by the given parametric equations and also find a corresponding xy equation for the curve. Okay, so the given curve will have parametric equations. For the x, it will be t squared minus 1. And for the y, it's going to be 2t. Okay, so first what we can do, we can find the x and y using the parameter t, starting from t is equal to 0, okay, and increasing values of t. When t is equal to 0, x is equal to negative 1, y is equal to 0, okay. Okay, when t is equal to 1, we will have x is equal to 0, y is equal to 2. When t is equal to 2, we will have 1 for the x, 4 for the y. When t is equal to 3, we will have 8 for the x. Okay. And we'll have 6 for the y. So that's enough for now. So let's actually plot this in the xy plane. Okay, so let's plot those points. So we will need 8 ticks for the y, for the x, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We will need a negative 1 here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so negative 1, 0. That's here. Well, let's actually use the red one. Negative 1, 0 is here. 0, 2 is here. 1, comma 4, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4 is here. And then 8, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 6. Okay. So notice it's not a straight line. Okay. Which it should make sense. Let me check those. Negative 1, 0, 1. T is equal to, I'm just going to check those quickly again. Negative 1, 0, t is equal to 1, 0, 2. Oh, for the x, I was wrong for the x. I should change my x a little bit. Sorry about that. The x should have been 4 minus, 3, 4, right? So, got to erase that one really quick as well. Okay, so that should be,3, comma 4, somewhere here, right? It's not as bright, yeah. That's the color. Okay, so yeah, so we will connect this, and as you can see, this resembles a half of a parabola, right? And what I'm saying is, what I'm suggesting is that this is a parabola that's symmetric with respect to the x-axis, right? So it will be a mirrored image of itself through the x-axis. So what I'm arguing is that for negative values of t, you will have the same values for the x and y. Okay, so, well, let's check that. Notice that t is squared for the x, so that's already making sense that the x values will not change. And since the x values will not change, only the y values will, right? Because the t is squared. So any t here will produce you the same x value, whether it's negative or positive. So it already makes sense. So when t is equal to 0, when t is equal to negative 1, right, because we're going to go negative values of t now, you will have 1 minus 1, which is 0, okay? And since the x values won't change, let's just check the y values to save time, right? So when t is equal to negative 1, y is equal to negative 2. See? Great. So it already confirms my suspicions that we have symmetry. When t is equal to negative 1, well, negative 2, actually, because we already checked negative 1. this will be negative 4, and the x value will be 3, the same. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. So definitely there is a symmetry involved, right? So I'm just going to connect these. Okay. And as you can see, this is indeed a parabola because there's symmetry. And let me just plot those two ticks. Okay, so this is 4. Okay, let's make it bigger like this. And so on and so on. Okay, so this last point here that would match the first point on the very top here would be 8, negative 6, right? Because the y values are negated. And that makes sense because if you check negative 3 for the y, for the t value of negative 3, this will give you negative 6 for the y. So it makes sense that there is indeed symmetry. So when there's symmetry, all in all, when there's a symmetry with respect to the x-axis, the x values will be the same, but the y values will negate each other. Okay, that's what symmetry about the x-axis means. Okay, so now that we use the x-y table and checked the t values and know that there's symmetry and we plotted everything in the x-y plane, let's find the x-y equation now. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write this, let me write it in green. So x is equal to t squared minus 1, y is equal to 2t. Notice right away that I can write y, I can solve for t here in the y equation. So y, dividing both sides by 2, okay, we will have t is equal to y over 2. Okay, and that way we can plug it in here. We can plug in this t value in terms of y in the first equation for the x. Okay, so we will get x is equal to y over 2 squared minus 1, right? Which means that you're looking for the equation x is equal to y squared over 4 minus 1. So indeed, what it says here is that it's a parabola with a vertex at x is equal to negative 1, and that's true here. It corresponds with the graph, right? Because when y value is 0, x is equal to negative 1, and that's exactly what we have here. So that's the vertex of this parabola. And this parabola opens up to the right, okay? It expands to the right of this value of negative 1 for the x. So as x increases, the y value just expands, the parabola expands. All right, so we can write this equation as x is equal to 1, 4, y squared minus 1. So this is your equation and this is your graph. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you want, and I'll see you in my next video.